Welcome or welcome back to Zooeytropy. I'm Zooey and I hope you enjoy today's video. But before we get right into it, I'm obligated to remind you to click either the like or dislike button, commenting something down below, and of course sharing the video so more people can see and enjoy it. This is very important as it helps with the YouTube algorithm. I want you to know that your help is greatly appreciated. If you have any suggestions or ideas for a story, my Discord link is in my link tree that is down in the description, as well as my Patreon and Ko-fi for any donations you may want to send my way. Every cent counts. Anyways, I hope you enjoy today's video.
UA was a prestigious school. Delinquency was forbidden, and it was a privilege to attend it. However, this didn't mean everyone was following the rules all the time. There were a few punishments for rule breakers. Most of the time it was expulsion. This kept most students in check. However, there were a select few students exempt from this. This was when a student either was too influential due to the power of their parents, or the student's quirk was simply too powerful to risk being kicked out, and then out of sheer spite joined the League of Villains. Something you would totally do. Because of your constant breaking of the rules, you were a regular in detention. A delinquent. Detention was a 2-hour period after school had ended, where you were under the watchful eyes of the hero Snipe. For detention, the hero had been given a slingshot and a few pebbles. By now, you and Snipe had built a hostile friendship, where he reprimanded you constantly, while you gave sarcastic comments and mild flirts his direction. Of course, you weren't attracted to your teacher, but he always left the room with a frustrated grunt when I went too far. It was a joy to watch. Today, you had just managed to get Snipe to leave when the door suddenly swung open. It was your homeroom teacher. Face red from anger, followed by a rather embarrassed Bakugou entering.
"Where's Snipe?" barked Aizawa.
You shrugged.
"Said his mom called and he needed to leave."
Aizawa's eyes narrowed.
"His mother is dead," he growled.
And you raised an eyebrow.
"Well, if a dead family member suddenly calls, wouldn't you drop everything just to talk to them?"
Your teacher sighed, as he was too frustrated to argue with a delinquent like you. It was up to him, he'd kick you out in an instant, but he also was fully aware that if that were to happen, the first thing you'd do would seek out the League of Villains. Your teacher turned towards Bakugou.
"Sit down,"
before madly slapping the back of his head. The pissed-off Pomeranian boy mumbled something before sitting somewhere in the back of the classroom. Right behind you, in fact. Aizawa stayed in the room behind the teacher's desk, arms crossed. You highly doubted you could get Aizawa to leave by making stupid comments and flirtatious moves. Then you looked back at Bakugou. The blonde opened his bag and painfully, slowly began pulling out his books and notes. Annoyed, Aizawa leaned against the blackboard. He'd stay here until Snipe would return, or he was sure Bakugou and you would continue doing your extra work. Honestly, you didn't take Bakugou for the type of person to actually do anything in detention. So this was interesting and funny to you all the same. You stretched and yawned. Normally, you would pull out your mobile console that you snuck into school every morning and play. But something told you as long as Aizawa was here, that was a no-go. Lucky for you, the moment your brain said, "Hey, I'm bored, might as well do the work, eh?" your teacher received a call on his phone. He tried to ignore it. Desperately even. His eyes narrowing whenever the phone jingle repeated. And
after he was called a second time, Aizawa turned and left with an angry expression while pulling the communication tool out of his pockets. As soon as the door behind him closed, your entire attention was on Bakugou. Not only was it rare that someone else was with you in detention, it was unheard of that someone else from Class 1A would accompany you. 10 minutes of your staring at him passed before you seemingly blew a fuse.
"What the hell do you want, nerd?"
he shouted. You grinned and didn't answer.
What's up with that stupid grin? Can't you see I'm working?
It was cute seeing him try to actually do his homework, or whatever it was he was working on. Your grin turned smug.
"Why are you here?" he asked playfully.
"None of your business."
"Was it something you said?"
He growled but didn't answer.
"Was it something you did?"
Your mind was gleefully imagining all the dumb stuff he must have done to piss off Aizawa this much. You giggled.
"Did you piss in his morning coffee?"
Bakugou dropped his pen in disgust and looked at you.
What the hell is wrong with you?
You shrugged in response.
"Well, I'm gonna imagine worse and worse things up until you tell me."
And then you sighed ever so dramatically.
"I will probably be really disappointed."
He looked away.
"Making you disappointed would be something positive."
You chuckled, and then gave a few more guesses. You were about to tell him that he probably set Aizawa's family photos on fire when he finally opened his mouth.
"Okay, fine. I put chalk dust on his chair. Didn't you notice the powder on his ass?"
"You actually didn't." The blonde grinned. God, this was such a juvenile prank. Adorable, but you'd never expected something like this from him.
"Would have gotten away with it. But he about blew my cover a few minutes ago. Can't believe the extra managed to keep it to himself for more than 5 minutes.
You shrugged.
"Honestly, I can't believe any goody two-shoes in our class let you do it to begin with. I wish I had been there."
He gave a long sigh.
Maybe it's because no one was there. Let me explain. You still were with us during training, right? Before you got here?
You rolled your eyes.
Yes.
Okay, so I left early to, well, do it. Again, stupid prank, I know, shut up.
You snickered. And let me guess, Ida, because he's a complete and utter yes man, wanted to be first in class and open the door while you were in the middle of doing it.
I mean, you made it sound kind of dirty, but yeah,
was his only response.
And you?
You were surprised. Usually any misdeed committed traveled far in the school thanks to rumors.
I believe, the rumor mill. You beat up a student from general studies? You know, one of those quirkless losers?
You scoffed. "I wish." No, it was that preppy nerdy blondie from 1B. Stupid Nick, you go. That stupid twerp dared to insult me while I was bored. And we were outside, where my quirk is at its strongest.
The old prick is probably still picking up his teeth.
Bakugou shifted slightly uncomfortable. Your quirk was called Patron of Stone, and allowed you to manipulate rocks with telekinesis. This meant that rocks and pebbles became mind-controlled projectiles around you. But you also used it to reinforce your body with a coat of, well, stones. Your quirk had made Kirishima very jealous. So when the pompous dickhead was hurting your pride, you hit him straight in the face with a rock-hard fist to the teeth. The conversation died down, and just when Bakugou resumed writing, you opened your mouth.
So So, like, how long do you have detention now?
He growled.
Rest of the week.
Hugh grinned. For that prank? Hilarious. Then you lean forward on your chair.
Wanna do something afterwards?
He glanced at you.
Like what?
Well, I just happen to have a fake ID. I could get us some alcohol and then we spent the rest of the day in a park getting drunk.
He raised an eyebrow skeptically. Your heart began to beat ever so slightly faster. And a mild blush came to his face.
Maybe, he grumbled.
Your grin widened, and he scoffed.
What?
He barked.
This is gonna be awesome, you giggled.
He crossed his arms, scoffing once more.
Why do you think getting drunk with a nerd like you will be awesome?
You chuckled confidently.
The best thing about getting drunk with friends is seeing how they act when they're drunk. I bet you become really handsy and soft.
His eyes narrowed.
I'll kill you.
He mumbled just loud enough for you to hear. You raised one hand and retorted.
I hereby solemnly swear, if you don't like it, I'll let you do whatever you want with me.
You purred. Bakugou's eyes widened and his face turned even more red. Immediately looked outside a nearby window.
Oh, are you thinking dirty thoughts, Katsuki? I mean, when I say I let you do whatever you want, I mean it.
Licking your lips, you lean forward.
Puberty is a bitch, isn't it, Bakugou?
You chuckled.
Tell me what depraved thoughts you were having, Bakugou. Come on, I don't have all day.
He shook his head.
What? Is the big bad wolf losing his teeth already? Oh, I expected more from you.
Your words hit Bakugou's ego like a knife. Aggressively, the blonde slammed both hands on the desk.
What the hell is wrong?
He was interrupted by something warm and soft crashing against his lips. Katsuki was so taken off guard, he couldn't help but hum. As the moment the blonde had jumped up to shout at you, you had taken the initiative and lunged at him first. His little moans were cute. And his kissing ability, well, was not so bad either. Definitely not your worst kiss just yet. You reached out, cradling his neck with your hands, as you hungrily pressed further into him, only to then nonchalantly letting go of him. His face akin to a tomato, his body hot, heart beating faster than ever before. This had been his first kiss, and you stole it. And by God, he would burn it into his memory. Even though outwardly, he looked at you with pure rage.
What the hell was that for?
Katsuki wanted to shout, but all he could produce was a mere hush of a scream.
You gave Katsuki a seductive look. Well, believe me now. And are you gonna accompany? God damn it. Well, do you believe me now? And will you accompany me, big boy?